What is up, party people? Welcome back to the Rock of Ages tour after 2 weeks off. We all joined up back in Wausau, Wisconsin to have our 177th performance at the sold-out Grand Theater. The theater sat just over 1,200. And halfway through the show, I lost my voice, which is not something that happens to me very often. That was fun. So of course, me being a hypochondriac, I assumed I had nodes or esophageal cancer because I had acid reflux and I'm more likely to get it because of that. Wausau is a gorgeous city. It was cool being in Wausau because the whole tour, Steven's been going, Wausau, dude. So we did our one night in Wausau, and then we headed to Bloomington, Illinois to perform at the Bloomington Center for the Arts, which seats just over 1,320. I did not perform at Bloomington Center for the Arts because I did not have a voice. So instead, I went to urgent care while everybody else was doing the show. And I got some steroids, tried to schedule an appointment with an ENT while we were still gonna be in Bloomington, but that didn't work out. So I had to schedule an appointment with the ENT in Kansas City, Missouri. We played the Starlight Theater, which is a gorgeous outdoor venue, which seats just under 8,000. In Kansas City, we did not have Mark. Mark was away at a wedding. I don't know if I'm allowed to say that because I haven't talked to Mark about it yet. But Mark was out of the show all weekend, so I went on for the role of Joey Primo. I also got into the ENT in Kansas City, found out that I don't have nodes. Also, my friend Daryl told me that it's really hard for guys to get nodes. I didn't know that. It turns out my acid reflux had just been affecting me more than I realized. And I had a burger before the show, and because it was too close to the actual show, I probably had some acid reflux happening during the show and didn't even realize it. Just hurt myself during the show. So, short 5-day run of prednisone, cleared that all up, back in the show, doing the thing, you know? Acid reflux is tough on tour because you can't have a regular eating schedule that is cohesive with acid reflux. Because you're not supposed to eat before you do any strenuous activity, and you're not supposed to eat before bed. So I can eat like at noon, like a regular human being. I can eat breakfast, I can eat lunch, but dinner time becomes very difficult because usually we're at the theater at about between 4 and 5 p.m. for our company meeting and for our vocal warm-up and just getting ready to do the show. I can't eat dinner before 4 o'clock and then not be hungry at the end of the day. And I also can't eat right before the show because if I do that and then I do the show, or doing all the jumping around and the dancing, then I've got acid all up in my esophageal cavity. And then if I wait till after the show to eat, then it's too close to bedtime, and I'm gonna have acid coming up in my sleep. I can't win. So I guess I'm just not eating anymore. That's not true, but I'm eating more for breakfast and lunch and eating less for dinner time because antacid just doesn't work. I've tried every single one. I'm sure it works for most people. In case you weren't interested in antacid in my personal battle with GERD, I apologize. Been a crazy week. Kansas City's been great. Went to go see Rocket Man at the Alamo Draft House here in Kansas City. And I think it's gonna be a long, long time till touchdown brings me round again to a fine. I'm not the man they think I am at home. Oh no, no, no. I had a very good time. It's probably one of my favorite biopics. Terry Egerton, everything you can say. I didn't know that. We're gonna go to bed now. Gonna get on the bus and then get on the airplane and fly to Buffalo. Next stop, Buffalo, New York. Thanks so much for coming out. Chase your dreams and cheers. Yeah.